You might think the most dangerous thing that can happen at a beach is a shark attack, or that the scariest thing might be a tsunami. But instead, rip currents, narrow channels of water that appear seemingly out of nowhere to pull unsuspecting swimmers out to sea, kill more beachgoers than all other causes combined. So why are they so deadly, and what can you do to avoid them? Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. When waves spill forward, it's called a break, and breaks push water against the beach, piling it up in the surf zone, and the bigger the wave breaks are, the bigger the piles get. But sometimes water piles higher up the shore in some places than others. This is unstable, so instead of simply flowing back into the ocean the way it came, the water from the higher piles will instead flow downhill toward smaller piles, then out to sea, and a rip current is born. Changes in wind direction and intensity, or features on the shore that can affect wave breaks, can cause the size of wave piles to vary and create rip current conditions. But the most dangerous rip currents are the ones caused by sandbars. Because sandbars are shallow, waves trip over them, creating large wave breaks. What's more, sandbars act like a dam that traps water in the surf zone. The danger comes from the fact that sandbars are constantly and unpredictably shifting, and when a gap opens up in a sandbar, two things will happen. First, because the gap is deeper than the surrounding sandbar, wave breaks won't be as big over the gap as they are over the sandbar, so the water will pile up on the beach at different rates. Second, the gap acts like a drain for outflowing water, funneling the rip current out to sea. Rip currents typically move 1 to 2 feet per second, with the fastest topping 8 feet per second, and most of them can easily overpower even the best swimmers and carry them away from shore. So even if you're Michael Phelps, don't even think about trying to swim against a rip current. There are, however, two potential escape routes that beach safety experts recommend if you're ever caught in one. Because rip currents are often pretty narrow, one option is to swim parallel to shore and out of the current. But if swimming to one side isn't possible, possibly because of exhaustion, another option is just to let the rip current carry you, which sounds terrifying. But rip currents don't run forever out to sea, they tend to fan out as they move away from the beach. So if you can float or tread water long enough, you're likely to meander back into the waves and get pushed to a sandbar, where the water is likely shallow enough to stand. Now, can someone come get me? Speaking of current events, we just launched two awesome new things. The first is called Just a Minute, and it's a free bi-weekly newsletter about everything going on in the minute world, featuring behind-the-scenes drawings, links to science news and videos that have caught our eye, and even our own custom games. Seriously, we are creating brand new science-themed connections, quizzes, and crossword puzzles for each edition. You can sign up at the link in the description. Second, we have gorgeous new merch. If you're sad that Pride Month is over, join us in celebrating the beauty of diversity in all species on Earth every day of the year with a special t-shirt. It's available in our store at dfdba.com/minuteearth. Get your newsletter and your Pride shirt at the links in the description.